Hello, and thank you to JFN for inviting me to speak on this distinguished stage. I'll start off with a slightly different self-introduction in a very different time. My name is Inbar Shashua. I'm Jewish, Israeli, married to Gev, daughter of Anat and Amnon, granddaughter of Chava and Aaron, Holocaust survivors who fled from Hungary, and Hanina and Leon who immigrated from Iraq. I'm one of three siblings who served in the army and continue to serve in this period as well, each in their own capacity, like many, many others at our age. Lastly, my professional position. I'm the chairwoman of the Shashua Family Foundation, an Israeli philanthropic family foundation. And why am I telling you all this? Not because I think that there's a unique or different story here, but because I think that this combination between the personal story of who we are and where we came from, and our actions and the choice to engage in philanthropy every day, characterizes each of those present here, no matter where you come from, and especially now, when everything blends together. This is the beauty, the complexity, and the hope of a country like ours. These past complex months emphasized to me how significant philanthropy is a driving, initiating, and restorative force. As a next gen to the philanthropic social world, and as a professional in a field that has existed for years but is constantly developing, I see more than ever the importance of strategic giving, the need to learn, measure, and plan. This time, however, this kind of giving has received a bit of a different twist that probably happens only in real and extreme moments of crisis, such as October 7th. It requires philanthropy to play the role of the risk taker. Now, I would like to share with you three things that I learned. First, is crisis has a different rhythm. The most common question on October 7th was, what can we do? One of the advantages of philanthropy is that we were all able to provide quick and powerful assistance in a very short period of time, and in places that we identified that needed the assistance in order to survive, even if it doesn't exactly meet the strategic plan we had in mind in the beginning of the year. Second, is reinventing the box. If in normal times we try to think outside the box, then in times of crisis, it is no longer enough. In an event of this magnitude, there is a need to reinvent. One example is a project that started in our foundation called Reshet, that tackles two problems in one. As a means of ensuring small businesses' survival through buying their products and the need to provide equipment for nonprofits during an emergency, we started a project that makes this matchmaking possible. Of course, this is just one of many, many more new and innovative examples out there. Third is joining forces. In emergency times like this, all the economic, social, business, human links of existence collapse in one fell swoop. A multidisciplinary answer was therefore needed. From the collaborations that we took part in and the ones that have arisen around us, we see that there has been an Israeli and global understanding of the importance of collaborating between philanthropic foundations. The depth of the crisis requires powerful collaboration while creating the right environment to learn and to grow. It is no coincidence that we are all here today at such a significant JFN conference, which provides a valuable platform for dialogue between us. Let me finish by saying that beyond the great privilege to choose to do this kind of work and to belong to a community of people with such strong commitment to simply making our country a better place, I understand that there's an immense responsibility for an entire generation. During this period of time, I saw how young people rise to the occasion and took command. Like generations before us, we realized that first of all, there is no question that we are here to stay. We are here not only to survive and to hold things together, but to also restore and rebuild, each in his or her own capacity. Whether it fits through significant reserve service, through getting up every day to work and strengthening the economy, and whether it fits through taking social action. Thank you, and Toda Rabah.